Sit still and close your eyes. What's behind the other door?
Tapping into Blue Sun's communications. Stay tight and look out for ambushes.
Squad Bravo, a shuttle landed near your location. Check it out.
Here we go. Keep close. Shot in the back and left to rot. That's definitely Vito's style. Let's push ahead.
Friendly out.
Santiago. If any of you retreat while the intruders are still alive, I'll kill you myself. Now get the hell back out there!
Vito. Sounds like he hasn't changed.
I get the feeling you have a past with this, Vito.
I knew he was a sadistic bastard back when we started the Blue Suns. The Suns only got meaner after he staged his little coup 20 years ago. So, yeah, we have a past.
Why didn't anyone tell me you founded the Blue Suns?
Because it's not common knowledge. Vito wiped me out of the records. He ran the books, I led the men. Worked real well for a while. Then Vito decided to start hiring Batarians. Cheaper labor, he said. Goddamn terrorists, I said.
20 years is a long time to hold a grudge.
A grudge? Vito turned my men against me. He paid 6 of them to restrain me while he put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger. For 20 years, I've seen that bastard every time I closed my eyes, every time I sighted down on a target, every time I heard a gunshot. Don't you call that a goddamn grudge?
You survived a gunshot to the head?
Yeah. And you survived your ship getting disintegrated. A stubborn enough person can survive just about anything. Rage is a hell of an anesthetic.
We better get moving.
You're at the Southern Axis. All squads mass at the gatehouse. Now!
They know we're here. Bring it on, you son of a bitch!
Zaeed Masani, you finally tracked me down.
Vito.
Don't be stupid, Zaeed. I have a whole company of bloodthirsty bastards behind me, ready to kill or be killed on my command. Actually, take your shot. Give my men a reason to put you down like the mad dog you are. Again. What was that? Gone nearsighted, old friend.
Burn, you son of a bitch.
You just signed your death warrant, Masani.
What the hell are you doing?
Opening the gate.
We don't sacrifice lives for the sake of the mission. There's always a better way.
Like what? Wandering out in the jungle for hours looking for another way in? You want to waste time out here? Go ahead. I'm gonna kill Vito.
You're endangering lives and the mission for your own selfish revenge.
You really want to do this, Shepard?
I ought to knock you the hell out. Thanks to you, we have a burning refinery to save.
Let these people burn. Vito dies, whatever the cost.
Time to die!
He goes. Get shot!
Vito's probably halfway to the shuttle docks by now.
You're willing to watch these people die?
Damn right I am. We stop to help these people and Vito gets away. And if he gets away, I'm blaming you.
We're here to free these people. We're going in.
knew this was a mistake. If we're gonna do this, we'd better get to it.
This should come in handy.
Enemies in front!
Never shoot.
enemies in front!
Just cost me 20 years of my life. Ah, son of a bitch!
Zaeed, you all right?
The hell do you care? I'm fine. Now come on, get me out of this shithole.
I'm not sure I need a man like you on my ship.
If you didn't need me, Cerberus wouldn't have paid my fee. I'll do what I was paid to do. Nothing more, nothing less. Now stop screwing around. Let's go.
You put your own goals ahead of the mission. That is not the way this works.
I've survived this long watching my own back. No time to worry about anyone else.
You're part of a team now, Zaeed. There's no way we can do this unless we're all working together.
You have a point. I'm not done with Vito. But I can put that behind me long enough to get your mission done. Let's get the hell out of here.
Thank you.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Anything I should know regarding the Normandy?
The crew's working well, and the ship appears to be performing to specifications.
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
Of course. I'm just finishing an operation report. I'm impressed, Shepard. So far things have gone exceptionally well.
As Cerberus operations go, this is one of the best I've been a part of.
Maybe that's because this isn't a Cerberus operation.
Not to you, maybe. But I report directly to the elusive man, and I'm here because he wants me to be. Cerberus gave you a second chance, Commander. Maybe you should do the same for us.
What did Cerberus do that made you so loyal?
I suppose you deserve to know. Do you remember when I told you how I was genetically altered? Well, that wasn't my choice. My father created me. He's a very influential man and extremely controlling. He didn't want a daughter. He wanted a dynasty. I ran away as soon as I was old and brave enough. I went to Cerberus because I knew they could protect me.
You seem capable of defending yourself. Why did you need Cerberus?
My father invested a great deal in his dynasty. It wasn't a matter of just leaving. I knew he would continue to pursue his investments.
I assume that Cerberus approves of your enhanced abilities?
Of course. Cerberus fully endorses anything that advances the cause of humanity. Genetic alterations included. But unlike my father and his own selfish reasons, Cerberus and the elusive man believe in a greater good. They see the bigger picture, and I feel like I have a purpose here.
Who exactly is your father?
A businessman, but a very wealthy one. It's ironic, my father believed deeply in a human positive agenda. He donated generously to Cerberus before I joined them. That's how I first heard about Cerberus, through my father's connections.
You've told me a lot about your father. What happened to your mother?
I never had one. Most of my genetic material is based on my father's tissue. His Y chromosome was altered with an amalgam of desired traits from various sources. How arrogant can you be? The man is completely egomaniacal. Just another reason I had to get away from him.
Talk about yourself like you're just a tool to be used. By your father? By Cerberus?
Maybe. I like to know where I fit in the world. It helps me find meaning in how I was created.
You are who you are, Miranda. You don't need to make excuses for it.
That's easy for you to say. We've both been engineered for greatness, Shepard. The difference is, you were great before we rebuilt you. I'm great because of it.
Your spirit and personality are what make you great. It's what makes anyone great.
That's kind of you. I'm not sure I believe you, but thanks for saying it.
Thanks for your time, Miranda. I'll talk to you later.
Anytime, Commander.
Garrus put some crazy tech into the main guns. It's almost doubled their power draw.
But they seem pretty wicked.
Indeed. Don't worry. A few tweaks to the forward capacitors, and the balance is back in line.
Brother?
It's gone. They're all gone. But we'll get them back.
Shepard and Lawson are on it. We'll get your brother back. And make sure the collectors pay for taking him.
Commander.
I assume everything's going well up here?
I really want a chance to put the Normandy through her paces. I just have to trim up the drive output and it'll be like we never lost her.
Safety standards advise against manipulating drive settings while engines are powered and in use, Mr. Moreau.
Commander, can we shut this thing off? I don't need it in my day-to-day.
I'm no fan either, but we're stuck with it.
Until I find a soldering gun. There's gotta be some wires I can cross to make it hurt.
No sabotage. Understood?
Yeah, don't break the boss's toys.
So, how do you think we're doing?
Well, the Normandy's not as ready as she could be. There's always more we could upgrade. As for the crew, you'd have to ask a people person.
What do you think about the people we're picking up?
Well, about the ones you went out with last. I would never say anything against Miranda and expect to survive the reprisal. Zaeed is like you, but takes checks. As long as it's not my money, we're good. It's just my opinion, though. There's really no need to go spreading it around.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Shepard, enter the password and receive a free gift. problems with collectors, try Kasumi's credit services. Please tell me your password, Commander Shepard.
Silence is golden.
Good to finally meet you, Commander Shepard.
Kasumi Goto.
I'm a fan.
Has Cerberus filled you in on the mission?
Honestly, I'm shocked they didn't come to see me sooner. My fault for being hard to find, I guess.
What's with the password and the sneaking around? Are you in trouble or something?
I'm the best thief in the business, not the most famous. Need to watch my step to keep it that way. I also needed to make sure all this was legit. And I have no doubts now. You're the real Commander Shepard.
What makes you so sure?
There's a certain aura about you. Like you've seen things no one else has. Even without knowing what you looked like, I knew it was you.
What brought you to Cerberus?
That's a bit of a story. Short version, they were looking for me, so I trailed them to find out why. Turns out they were looking for someone to join you on an important mission, and were offering a serious signing bonus. I had a thing I needed help with, so I made them a deal. And here we are.
I assume this deal is something I should know about.
Yeah, I guess it slipped their minds. I'm looking for my old partner's gray box. A man named Donovan Hawk took it, and I'm planning to get it back.
What do you know about Donovan Hawk?
Mr. Hawk is a well-respected businessman. Arms dealer, murderer, generally not a great guy. His mansion's famous for being hard to crack, but I have a way in, and I think you're gonna love it.
I doubt Hawk's the kind of guy who takes kindly to people sneaking into his house.
I always expect trouble. That's why you're here.
I assume a gray box is some kind of hardware.
It's a neural implant. Illegal in most places. Stores memories, thoughts, secret codes, illicit information. This one in particular belonged to my partner, Keiji Okuda. We worked together for a long time, before Hawk killed him.
What's this heist you're planning?
Not here, Shepard. You'll get a briefing when the time comes. I need time to nail down the details anyway. I've taken the liberty of getting you some evening wear, though. You want to look presentable.
Tell me about this former partner of yours.
His name was Keiji Okuda. The best hacker and entryman I've ever known. Unfortunately, he slipped up and made himself infamous. He stole something he shouldn't. He warned me it was bad. Something that could spark interstellar war if it got out. That information got him killed.
What could he have found that's so bad?
He wouldn't say what it was, just that it was dangerous. He said if it got out, humanity would be in trouble. He encrypted it, wrapped it up in his own memories. To decode the information, you have to sift through all the time we spent together. Now those memories are all that's left of him.
I can understand why you'd want to get it back.
Getting it back will be easier with your help, Shepard.
If that's what Cerberus promised you, we'll get it done.
It'll be fun. And if we're lucky, you won't even have to draw your gun. We should probably wrap this up. You look pretty silly standing there talking to an advertisement. See you on the ship, Shepard.
This recruits is a 20-kilo ferrous slug. Feel the weight! Every 5 seconds, the main gun of an Everest-class dreadnought accelerates 1 to 1.3% of light speed. It impacts with the force of a 38-kiloton bomb. That is 3 times the yield of the City Buster dropped on Hiroshima back on Earth. That means Sir Isaac Newton is the deadliest son of a bitch in space. Now, Serviceman Burnside, what is Newton's first law?
Sir, an object in motion stays in motion, sir.
No credit for partial answers, maggot!
Sir, unless acted on by an outside force, sir.
Damn straight! I dare to assume you ignorant jackasses know that space is empty. Once you fire this hunk of metal, it keeps going till it hits something. That can be a ship, or the planet behind that ship. It might go off into deep space and hit somebody else in 10,000 years. If you pull the trigger on this, you are ruining someone's day, somewhere and sometime. That is why you check your damn targets. That is why you wait for the computer to give you a damn firing solution. That is why, Serviceman Chung, we do not eyeball it. This is a weapon of mass destruction. You are not a cowboy shooting from the hip.
Sir! Yes, sir!
I'm sorry, sir, but I'll need you to remove any biotic amp you might be wearing.
What? Why?
Unfortunately, sir, biotics can be used as a weapon. The rules require me to confiscate all amps. Could you please hand over yours?
I don't have one. I'm not a biotic.
Oh. Well, when you objected, I thought...
You humans are all racist.
Can I help you, ma'am?
It's been a couple years since I passed through here. Security seems to have tightened a bit.
After the Geth attack, there was a review of security protocol. A few minor changes were made to reduce the risk of Geth infiltration. We apologize for the inconvenience.
You think a Geth would stand out?
Assumptions are dangerous. Be alert, be safe.
Thanks for your time.
Next!
I thought it might be nice to come back here and see how it's changed, but it's just like it was. Same dirty streets, same unrepentant scavengers, same revolving door prisons. Being security here is a terrible job. This is exactly why I left.
The Destiny Ascension has completed its 20 colony victory cruise. Council members aboard thanked Human Alliance soldiers for their efforts in repelling Saren's invasion 2 years ago.
Figured they say something about our weapons.
Shut it down.
What? Do you seriously think?
Yeah, okay.
Sorry for the inconvenience, ma'am. Our scanners are picking up false readings. They seem to think you're... dead.
I was listed as missing in action a couple years ago.
Would you mind checking in with my captain? He can reinstate you in our system. He's just past the scanners on your right.
You'll have to make him scream a little. He's not gonna tell you everything just because you ask.
I know, sir.
If you don't have the stomach or you're worried about being reported, I can take care of it.
No, sir. I can handle it.
Yes. I see the problem already, Commander Shepard. My consul says you're dead.
You're not worried I'm some imposter claiming to be me?
We have the best screening equipment in the galaxy. Those scanners can sample DNA from skin flakes. Hell, if you have unregistered gene mods, they can even figure those out.
Your sergeant said you could help with that.
Usually you'd have to go through the station security administration to reactivate your IDs, then to customs and immigration to regain access to the Citadel itself, and probably a stop by the Treasury. Spending a year dead is a popular tax dodge. But I can see you're a busy woman. So how about I just press this button right here, and we call it done?
Couldn't one of us, or both of us, get into trouble for that?
There's no way to fool the DNA scanners in that tunnel. You're you. Why wait in long lines and fill out a mass of useless hard copy paperwork to get to the same place? The Council does everything by the book. They've had thousands of years to write it. Sometimes things need to get done without a committee vote.
You're not big on formalities, are you?
I'm with them right up until they keep people from doing their jobs. There. I just saved you about 9 days of running around. That said, you should head up to the Presidium and tell them you're still alive. The Council probably wants to talk to the one who saved their scaly asses.
What's the easiest way to get to the Presidium from down here?
Head back through the security checkpoint and take a public shuttle.
I will. Having access to the Council and the Spectre's resources would be useful.
Yeah. The Council can get anything. Best thing about working CSEC is that any equipment, information, or money you need, you get. Anyway, something else you need? Or can I get back to work?
How'd you end up working on the Citadel?
I started with the Alliance way back when, but the traveling was killing me. It's a shitty life if you're trying to raise a family, seeing your kids every 6 months. I joined CSEC so I could stay in one place, put down roots.
You like life here on the Citadel?
Life here is good. Hell of a lot different than life back on Earth. I miss the food, mostly. You just can't get sockeye salmon here on the station.
You ever get back there?
Earth, every couple of years, less and less all the time. But when I finish my stint with CSEC, there's a nice little place in the foothills I'm gonna retire to. Not that I'm retiring anytime soon.
It looks like most of the damage from Sovereign's attack has been repaired.
The Presidium was pretty shot up, of course they fixed that first. All the wards got hit with debris when the ship exploded. Most of the damage was superficial, and the Keepers got things restored fast. Tesseri Ward got the worst. A big chunk hit near the Dilanaga Concert Hall. They're still clearing wreckage and trying to get power restored.
Tell me about this place.
All the wards are more or less multicultural, but the other four are dominated by Asari, Turians, or Solarians. In Zakira, we've got major enclaves of Volus, Elkor, and Hanar. There's also a human commercial zone at Shin Akiba. We've got a few Krogan walking around. I think I saw a quarrying the other day.
Last time I was here, there were no human captains in CSEC.
No, CSEC took a lot of casualties when the Geth boarded the Presidium. The Special Response Division was hard hit. They stopped turning their noses up at human resumes. They needed bodies in uniform, and we had the most experienced bodies.
I overheard your conversation. Make him scream a little?
This isn't the Presidium. All they have to worry about are protesters outside their free speech zones or someone's poodle crapping on the grass. Down here, we have drugs, organized crime, and murder. Policing a ward is like policing New York City. Sometimes you have to work outside the Council's rulebook.
CSEC has changed.
I should be going.
You need anything else, let me know.
Shepard, are you looking to continue your education? It's one thing to know how to shoot a gun, but do you have the career skills to deploy and manage today's high-tech network infrastructures? The Henley Technical Institute can help. Courses available through our extranet site will put you on the path to success. Visit our site now at keywords Henley Technical Education.
This meeting would be more productive if Udina was to join us.
My advisor is unavailable. As counselor, I represent the voice of humanity and the Alliance. Shepard will be here and... Oh, Commander. We were just talking about you.
It's been a long time, Anderson. I hope the last couple years have treated you right.
There have been some rough spots. It's good to have you back.
We've heard many rumors surrounding your unexpected return. Some of them are unsettling.
We called this meeting so you could explain your actions, Shepard. We owe you that much. After all, you saved our lives in the battle against Saren and his Geth.
Saren wasn't the one commanding the Geth. It was the Reaper Sovereign.
Ah yes, Reapers. The immortal race of sentient starships allegedly waiting in dark space. We have dismissed that claim.
Shepard. No one else encountered the hologram on Ilos that told you the truth about the Reapers. Only you and your crew ever spoke with Sovereign. I believe you. But without evidence from another source, the others think Saren was behind the Geth attacks.
Saren was an organic. The Geth would never accept him as their leader. They only followed him because he was Sovereign's agent.
Saren was a compelling and charismatic individual. He convinced the Geth the Reapers were real, just as he convinced you.
It was part of his plan to attack the Citadel. The Reapers are just a myth, one you insist on perpetuating.
We believe that you believe it, but that doesn't make it true.
Go back to Ilos and talk to Vigil. Or just look at what's left of Sovereign. It's obvious the technology is more advanced than ours.
The hologram on Ilos is no longer functional, and we have found nothing to suggest that Sovereign was not a Geth creation.
The Geth are capable of remarkable technological achievements. This is probably why Saren recruited them.
This Reaper theory proves just how fragile your mental state is. You have been manipulated. By Cerberus, and before them, by Saren.
I kept Saren from conquering the Citadel. I sacrificed human lives to save this Council.
We are in a difficult position, Shepard. You are working for Cerberus, an avowed enemy of the Council. This is treason, a capital offense.
That's too far. Shepard is a hero. I'm on this council too, and I won't let this whitewash continue.
Maybe there is a compromise. Not a public acknowledgement, given your ties, but something to show peripheral support.
Shepard, if you keep a low profile and restrict your operations to the Terminus systems, the Council is willing to offer you reinstatement as a Spectre.
What does that mean? Will I need to start filing reports?
That won't be necessary. This is a show of good faith on our part.
We cannot become involved in an investigation regarding the missing colonies in the Terminus systems. But Spectre reinstatement shows our support of you personally.
I accept your offer. It's good to have the Council on my side.
Good luck with your investigation, Shepard. We hope for a quick resolution and a quick end to your relationship with Cerberus.
Well, that went better than expected. You realize the Council's offer is just symbolic. They won't actually do anything.
Even if they don't help, I might as well stay on good terms.
True enough. Don't worry about the Council or the Alliance. I'll find some way to keep them off your back. Shouldn't be too hard. As long as you keep to the Terminus systems.
Anderson, we need to talk about... Shepard, what are you doing here?
Stop by to see how Anderson was doing.
You don't have to cover for me. I invited Shepard here to speak with the Council. We just finished our meeting.
You what? Consular, do the words political shitstorm mean anything to you?
The Council reinstated my Spectre status. They're just happy I'm staying out in the Terminus systems.
Yes, I could see how that arrangement works best for both sides. But you really shouldn't have taken a step like this without consulting with me first, Counselor.
I don't answer to you, Udina. Why don't you go to your office and think about that for a while?
Of course, Counselor. Good day to both of you.
Sorry about that. Udina's never gotten over the fact that I got the Council position instead of him. Sometimes I need to put him in his place.
Udina's just doing his job.
True enough. He's got his uses. And if you want something done on the Citadel, he knows who can make it happen. Plus, he's always happy to attend all those formal diplomatic functions I can't be bothered with.
How have the last couple years treated you?
Serving on the Council isn't how I plan to spend my twilight years. Sometimes it feels like I'm just beating my head against a wall. Knowing the truth about Sovereign is brutal. It's nightmare stuff. I can't blame others for not wanting to believe it, but I know how important it is. So I keep trying. Fighting the good fight, right?
Forget Udina and the Council. Join my crew and help me stop the Collectors.
I'm too old to go racing across the galaxy. Much as I complain, I've got an important job to do here. The front line. That's got to be yours.
How long did it take to get this place back up to speed after the battle?
Still counting. The main areas of commerce and the most populated wards are complete. But estimates for total restoration are sitting around 5 years. The Keepers always surprise us, though. It's like our repairs are annoying. We'll put up an ugly new bulkhead, and in a few days, they've made it seamless. We never really thought of them as heavy lifters, and I have no idea where they get the resources. But we'd never get done without them.
I'm surprised no one can tell Sovereign isn't Geth technology. Didn't they examine the wreckage?
We don't have much to look at. Pieces of it rained all over the station. It was chaos, with who knows how many species combing the wards for their dead. We secured as much of it as we could. But between the Keepers and a whole lot of unauthorized salvage, there's no way to account for even half of that thing. Another reason why they don't want to acknowledge what Sovereign was.
Last I knew, we were still fighting holdouts.
Here and there. But they are increasingly disorganized. It's long since stopped being called a war. More like cleanup. Not that you can ever discount them. But we haven't had serious casualties for months. A civilian ship will spot an enclave, and we send in a squad to clear it. They're not quite the boogeymen they used to be.
What happened to Gunnery Chief Williams after the Normandy was destroyed?
Operations Chief Williams is still with the Alliance, but she's working on a special mission. It's classified. I can't say any more. Not while you're working with Cerberus. I'm sorry.
I better go.
Of course, Shepard, I understand. I wish I could do more to help you. But if you ever want to talk, I'll be here. Just do me a favor and be careful. You can't trust Cerberus.
This Cladness is a thief, and I want her arrested.
What? I was just walking by.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to take a statement here.
There's nothing to talk about. She stole my credit chit. Arrest her.
I did not! Just because I'm a Quarian.
I need you to stop and take a deep breath.
You're mocking me, Earth Clan. Just because the Vault Clan need...
It was a poor choice of words, sir. I apologize.
You say you're falsely accused?
I was walking to the used ship, Teeler, when he barged into me outside the Serta Foundation. He didn't stop or say he was sorry. A minute later, he runs up with C-Sec and accuses me of stealing his damn chip.
Do you spend a lot of time at the used ship dealer?
Yeah. They've got a lot of nice models. I'd like to buy one and take it back to the fleet, but...
A ship would make a great pilgrimage gift.
You know about the pilgrimage?
I traveled with Quarian, who was on hers.
Wow. I didn't know anyone here would do that for one of us.
Do you know who's telling the truth?
My Omni-tool can tell the Quarian doesn't have a chit on her. But she could have stashed it to recover later. You know what Quarians are like. And she's definitely a vagrant. I'll run her in and see what Bailey wants to do with her.
You say she stole your credit chit?
She must have. When I left the Serta Foundation store, she ran right into me.
How does running into you mean she stole your credit chit?
That's how pickpockets work. They bump into you and use that as a cover for rifling your pockets. You can't turn your back on these clanless Quarians. Thieves. All of them.
Are you sure you didn't leave your chit at the Serta Foundation?
Of course not. You'd think I'd make a mistake like that. I didn't even buy anything there. That chit stayed in my pocket.
I'll see if I can find out what happened.
Ma'am, this is a C-Sec matter. We'll do all we...
Bah!
All we can to resolve this. We don't need civilian help. If you do happen to find the chit, please let one of our officers know.
Let's go.
Be careful out there.
There's a Volus outside who lost his credit chit. Did you happen to see him drop it anywhere?
I don't recall any other Vol clan entering my showroom today. Just that migrant clan girl putting her fingers all over the brochures again.
Thank you. Good day, citizen. Welcome to the Serta Foundation outlet on Zakira Ward.
Avolus was in here not too long ago. Did he drop a credit chip?
And not that I saw. He didn't purchase anything.
I couldn't help but notice your prices. They seem a bit steep.
With respect, the Foundation is not concerned with profits. A portion of our sales funds research to cure genetic diseases.
You know, it would make your services more popular. An endorsement from the woman who defeated Saren.
Oh my! You're Shepard, aren't you? I would be glad to give you my employee discount if you would do that for us.
It's a deal.
Just speak into my console here.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
I'll work it into our advertising at once. Thank you.
Oh, what's this?
What do you think, Michael? Maybe the immuno booster?
Welcome to Sarenus Applications. Can I interest you? Ah, Shepard!
Do I know you?
No, but I know you. Even a senile Hanar would remember the human who fought off the Geth. I thought you were dead.
Yeah, I've been getting that a lot.
Please, look around the store. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Avolus was in here not too long ago. Did he drop a credit chip?
Oh, yes. He bought some environmental system drivers, then left without his chip. I didn't notice he'd left until he was already gone. If you see him, tell him I have it here behind the counter.
You know, I use quite a bit of software in my line of work.
It's a shame so few understand their own equipment. Besides the most obvious point-and-go nav interfaces, anyway.
You wouldn't believe how often I hear, "Why is the ship turning around? We're only halfway there."
Oh, I would.
You know, I like your products. Any interest in an endorsement from the human who defeated Saren?
I'd be thrilled. But I don't think I could afford to pay you for it.
Don't worry about it. What if we just worked out a discount?
Absolutely. Just speak into my console here.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store in the Citadel.
That will be splendid. I can edit that and have it working right away. Thank you so much.
We can use this!
I felt her hand go...
Please move along.
You forgot your credit chip at Sarenus Applications. The clerk's holding it for you.
Oh. Well... The Quarian could have stolen it.
I'll close his event report, but I'll be watching you. Get a permanent residence, or I'll run you in for vagrancy.
Are you too serious?
What?
You falsely accused this girl of stealing from you. All you have to say now is that she could have stolen it.
Now, just a minute.
And you? She gets harassed and insulted by this guy, and you throw in a threat to arrest her for vagrancy.
How about if I run you in for obstruction of justice?
You think you're gonna run in a Spectre? I think both of you should get out of here.
Son of a...
Thank you. I wish I could give you something more than words.
Can you take care of yourself from here?
I guess. I mean, most nights I eat nutrient paste in a Turian shelter. But I'm surviving. Thanks.
You ever had ramen? It's a delicacy back on Earth.
I hear this is the best place for food on Zaeed Ward.
You heard wrong. This is the best place for food on the whole damn Citadel.
good day, my friends. Welcome to the Citadel.
Since these stores are owned by the Council, do government employees get a discount?
Yes, in fact. What's your position?
I'm a Spectre.
That is quite a prestigious role. It is my pleasure to extend the government employee discount to you, Spectre. Please, feel free to check the updated prices.
Lakes up on the Presidium are filled with fish.
No, they're not.
You ever been up there?
No. CSEC won't let me. They say I'm at risk.
What can I do for you?
Your expeditions might be a little tame for me.
Tame? A human can hardly take down a feral Varan, let alone a Shatha. Who do you think you are?
Well, my name's Shepard, and I...
The Shepard? The one that put down Saren Arterius?
Oh, you do know me.
By the spirits! Shepard, in my store! I don't suppose I could convince you to record an advertisement for me.
Sure you could. Can we work out a discount?
A discount? I'd name my firstborn after you if you ask. Can we record it now? Just speak towards my console.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
No other gun shop has that kind of endorsement.
Oh, what's this?
Have you tried Galaxy of Fantasy yet? I love that game. It's based on Turian mythology, but it's really fun. I hear it has 11 billion players now.
Shepard, you've recently been dead. Don't you deserve the quality and distinction of a traditional Asari burial robe? Anata's mortuary offers the finest quality burial robes, hand-spun by skilled Asari artisans. Anata's will help you leave a good-looking corpse.
You're one of the groundskeepers for Presidium. Do you know if there are fish in the lakes?
I get that question a lot. I think it's right behind where's the restroom. Those are reservoirs. The Presidium's own supply, independent from the water storage tanks in the wards. The only place I know of on the station to get a live fish is Delaeus Sonnesi's gift shop.
When I pour a glass of water, it's the same stuff tourists throw garbage in.
No, they purify it first. Some Solarian or human bacteria gets left in, and a Turian or Quarian drinks it, they could die. Everything would be so much simpler if we all had the same DNA. But no, the universe loves diversity.
Thanks for your time.
No problem. If you get up to the Presidium, check out the Demile flowers across from the conduit. They're coming in very nicely.
People want to hear your story, Shepard.
Kalisa been seen in Al-Jalani, Westerland News. I interviewed you 2 years ago when you first became a Spectre. You presented your case very well on camera. Do you have a minute?
What, so you can try to do another smear job on me?
Now, Shepard, you may object to my methods, but we're on the same side. You're bad, you're news. I just want to give your story its due. Sources claim you were at the heart of the Presidium during the Battle of the Citadel. It's fair to say the course of the battle hinged on your words. If true, you told Admiral Hackett to assist the Destiny Ascension, costing hundreds of human lives, and securing the continued dominance of the Citadel Council.
The Turians lost 20 cruisers. Figure each had a crew of around 300. The Ascension, the Asari dreadnought we saved, had a crew of nearly 10,000.
But surely the human cost.
The Alliance lost 8 cruisers. Shenyang, Emden, Jakarta, Cairo, Seoul, Cape Town, Warsaw, Madrid, and yes, I remember them all. Everyone in the Fifth Fleet is a hero. The Alliance owes them all medals. The Council owes them a lot more than that. And so do you.
Commander Shepard, first human Spectre. Hero of the Battle of the Citadel. Check vid. We get it? Great. Bull rushed on my own show.
Been years since I've been to the Citadel. Never changes, does it? No matter how long you're gone. Comforting to some people, I guess. Living in denial that all this could end.
Do you have any games you'd like to trade in? You get 2 credits toward a new game.
What do you want?
Why are you so interested in fish from the Presidium?
It's so decadent. Eating a fish from the Presidium would be like screwing Shaira.
Ugh, Asari are so squishy. Where are you supposed to get a decent grip?
I talked to one of the Presidium groundskeepers. He said there aren't any fish in the lakes.
What?
I told you.
Why have all that water if you're not going to store something to eat in it? I don't understand aliens at all.
Thanks for telling me. It's all he's talked about all damn day.
I'm sorry, but I can't let you board the shuttle with that.
But this is a ceremonial item of my people!
Sir, it's a 15-centimeter serrated blade.
You humans are all racist!
I told you.
Why have all that water if you're not going to store something to eat in it? I don't understand aliens at all.
Thanks for telling me. It's all he's talked about all damn day.
I'm sorry, but I can't let you board the shuttle with that.
But this is a ceremonial item of my people.
Sir, it's a 15-centimeter serrated blade.
You humans are all racist.